Hello everyone, myself Dr. Vindhya Ki, Junior Resident, Department of Radio Diagnosis, Mysore Medical College and Research Institute. Today I'm presenting a paper on the role of multi-detector computed tomography in characterization of mediastinal masses. Introduction: the mediastinum is strategically located from the thoracic inlet to the diaphragm. Mediastinal lesions include a wide spectrum of pathologies. These lesions are challenging problems frequently faced by the radiologist, and often a plain chest radiograph is inadequate for answering the queries posted by the physician. In past, patients had to undergo mediastinoscopy or thoracotomy to establish a diagnosis. Preoperative discrimination of mediastinal solid tumors based on imaging findings might be useful because thoracotomy could be avoided for certain lesions. Ultrasonography is not currently used in mediastinal mass evaluation because of the limitation due to inadequate acoustic window. Computed tomography is capable of defining the precise anatomical details and characterizing the nature, site, and the extent of mediastinal lesions. With the high-resolution multi-detector computed tomography scans, it is easy to localize biopsy needles for diagnostic fine needle aspiration or core biopsy in both benign and malignant diseases. The mediastinum is divided into anterior, middle, and posterior mediastinum for the ease of differential diagnosis of the mediastinal masses. Aims and objectives of our study was to characterize different mediastinal masses by multi-detector computed tomography and to correlate the diagnosis with histopathology. We also aim to differentiate between the benign and malignant lesion based on imaging characteristics. Materials and methods: with a sample size of 40, a hospital-based cross-sectional study was conducted on all patients referred to the Department of Radio Diagnosis, MMCRI, with a clinical or radiological suspicion of mediastinal mass. MDCT of the chest was performed. Lesions were characterized based on location, attenuation characteristics, and associated findings. Histopathology was performed wherever possible. Results: lesions were most common between 46 to 60 years. 72% of the lesions were benign, most commonly distributed in the anterior compartment and had a well-defined margin. Most lesions showed soft tissue attenuation and heterogeneous contrast enhancement. Thymic lesions were most common in anterior compartment and neurogenic tumors in posterior compartment. The diagnostic accuracy over histopathology was 91% in our study. Coming to the few representative images, thymoma, it is the most common primary neoplasm of the thymus, seen in 50 to 60 years. On contrast enhanced CT, we can see a well-defined soft tissue attenuation lesion in the anterior mediastinum. They usually show gross asymmetry to one side of the mediastinum. 30% of the lesions can be locally aggressive or invasive. Thymic neuroendocrine tumor, most commonest is the atypical carcinoid. On contrast enhanced CT, they show heterogeneous enhancement with areas of calcification, mediastinal invasion, and distant metastasis. Teratomas, they show on post-contrast study, they show heterogeneous enhancement with areas of fluid-filled cyst, fat, soft tissue component, and calcifications. Pericardial cyst, on contrast enhanced CT, they appear as a well-defined non-enhancing fluid attenuation lesion next to the pericardium. Lymphomas show homogeneously enhancing lesion in the anterior and middle mediastinum, encasing the vessels but not invading it. Ectopic thyroid in mediastinum is very rare, and here we can see a well-defined heterogeneously enhancing in the lesion in the anterior mediastinum, which was histologically proven case of ectopic thyroid. Schwannomas are the most commonest nerve-shaped tumors. On contrast enhanced CT, they appear as heterogeneously enhancing lesions in the paraspinal region, and the heterogeneous enhancement is because of the cystic and hemorrhagic areas within. Ganglioneuroma is more commoner in children older than 10 years, and on contrast enhanced CT, we can see an elongated lesion in the posterior mediastinum. Contrast enhancement, we can see only slight to moderate enhancement. Discussion: our study comprises a total 40 cases, out of which 29 were benign and 11 were malignant. This correlated with a study by Strahl et al., Benjamin et al., Harmit Kaur et al. In our study, mediastinal masses were common in 46 to 60 years of age. This correlates with a study by the Vinod et al., Singh et al., and Harmit et al. We found an equal incident of mediastinal masses among both sexes in our study, which correlates well with a study done by Vinod and Harmitkar et al. Comparing the compartment distribution with other study, we found that the anterior compartment was most common, followed by posterior and the middle compartment. And comparing the accuracy of the MDCT with various studies, we found the similar results, and the accuracy was about 91%. Concluding, although chest radiograph forms the initial investigation, multi-detector CT forms the investigation of choice for evaluating suspected cases of mediastinal masses. Post-processing techniques like MPR and VRT allow lesions to be analyzed in all three planes with good spatial resolution. Together with associated imaging features like encasement of vessels, calcification, fat components, thyroid communication, etc., the imaging characteristics and compartmental localization point towards a specific diagnosis and helps in the narrowing down of the differential diagnosis. Thus, CT in the hands of good radiologists will save the patient from unnecessary exposure to expensive and invasive procedures. These are my references. Thank you.